Major Jump.
Ooh, that sounds like a soldier. Major Jump.
All salute Major Jump, sir.
Hello. Millie's not here. She's in there, in Lulu. Now, I bet you can't guess what we've just been making. Give you a clue? You can't see it, touch it, or smell it. What? I know what you're thinking. Aunt Barking, you must be stark raving flip-flop. Give you a clue? It's... noises! Right, Millie?
Yes.
What?
Noises! Noises!
Yes, we've been playing a noise game with Aunt Barking's noise machine.
Did I ever tell you about my act with my friend Nora McKinnery called What's My Noise?
Yes.
I could do it now.
No, but we've been working on some great sounds for my model. We've already done the factory. Listen.
Model, yes. My machine is going to make some more noises for your model. And you have to guess where they're coming from. You too, Millie. All right? Good. Now, I press a knobble.
Don't you mean a button?
These are called knobbles. Where's this from?
Ah, it's a fire engine coming from the fire station.
Absolutely right!
Oh, it's Jonas Stoner thumping on the ceiling again.
Come out!
We don't want him down here, so let's find a nice quiet noise.
Righto.
Is that what this red knobble's for?
Never, never touch the red knobble.
Oh.
Right. Oh, I wasn't expecting that.
You trod on Fat Cat.
Oh, sorry. Right, press the knobble.
Ah, now that's birdsong. So it can't be the supermarket or the library. I know, it's birds singing in the park.
As a guess, I'd say yes.
A loud noise and quiet noise.
Da 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 da. Okay, we've done your model sounds. Now let's do the act. Millie, you do Nora's bit. Nora McKinnery's noisy machinery, totally tried and tested. Just press a knobble, the thing starts to wobble, and out comes the sound you've requested.
Try clapping.
Righto. Clap, 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 clap. Louder and louder it grows. Clap, 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 clap. Now turn it off by pressing your nose.
My turn.
Be my guest.
Nora McKinnery's noisy machinery. Totally tried and tested. Just press a knobble, the thing starts to wobble, and out comes the sound you've requested.
Try mooing.
Right.
Moo.
Louder and louder it grows. Moo. Now turn it off by pressing your nose.
Now for Nora's favourite. Nora McKinnery's noisy machinery, totally tried and tested. Just press a knobble, the thing starts to wobble, and out comes the sound you've requested. Listen to this. Louder and louder it grows. Now turn it off by pressing your nose.
Thank you so much for being quiet.
Mr. Stoner.
The Moaney owner.
Sorry, Mr. Moaner. Stoner?
There's a rule in here, number 10, which I call the no noise at any time, especially now rule, which clearly states...
No noise at any time, especially now.
Sorry, Mr. Stoner.
Yeah, well, I'm off to visit Lulu.
There's someone in there. Mm.
What are you hiding?
Have you seen my new model?
Model? No. Why would I be interested in your model? What's the point? Any more noise and you're out. And then who looks after this, eh? Yes, well. Why don't you sing a quiet song? Hinnery, heinery, rhymery, truff.
Oh, Millie, the machine.
I'll go and turn it off.
Millie, don't touch the red knobble.
Why not? What happens?
All the noises in the machine go off at once. It's what happened to poor Nora.
Now, cheer up, Aunt B. Do you want to see my research video?
Oh, yeah.
This week, I went to a shoe factory.
Oh, I know it well.
Hello, Millie. I'm Simon. Welcome to a shoe factory. As you can see, it takes a lot of people and a lot of noise to make our shoes, so let's go somewhere a little quieter.
Oh, yes. Jonas Stoner would like it in here. It's much quieter.
Oh, yeah.
Aye. Look at those wonderful colours.
To make shoes, we need leather. Here it's being checked, and the bad bits are being marked. In the next room, the leather is cut into the right shapes using these metal stencils.
Oh, and these machines punch out all the shapes. I can see a friendly face down there.
Hello, Millie. Give my regards to Aunt Barkin.
Thanks, I will.
And here are all the pieces for the top of the shoe. Leather can be decorated in lots of different ways, like this.
Oh, yes, stamping patterns. There's a great clunking noise. And stitching patterns. I like those colours. I wouldn't mind a pair of shoes like that. Mm.
And then all the pieces are stitched together.
Well, there's a difficult job. You have to stitch really carefully. I wonder which bit of the shoe this is. Of course, it's the top of the shoe.
Next, the shoe has to be shaped by a special machine which stretches the leather.
There's a great noise. And this machine folds the leather neatly round the shoe and then, look, sticks it with glue. Oh, what a great noise. Pssht.
Hello, Millie. This is a good machine. Press the knobble and sticks the soles to the shoe.
Another way is to stitch the top of the shoe to the bottom.
Wow, that's fast. And now for the finishing touches. A spot of cleaning and polishing. And we're all done.
Finally, all the shoes are packed in boxes, ready to go to the shops.
And then the new shoes get their first outing.
That was great! Now, I wonder if I can make some more factory noises on my machine.
What machine?
Shin. I bang my shin on the table. Ow.
Is Lulu free yet?
Yeah. No.
Was that your model?
B. It was me.
Do that again.
She's amazing, you know. She can do anything. Just like the gadgets in my story.
Story?
Story.
Yes. You see, once there was a family called the Gizmod family. Lizzie Gizmod.
More glamour tea, please.
Mrs. Gizmod.
Shush.
And Mr. Gizmod.
Too loud, Lizzie. Be quiet.
Or there'll be a riot.
Mr. and Mrs. Gizmod worked in a gadget factory.
Why don't we make a machine to feed our Lizzie?
Good idea.
So they made a feed-it-yourself gadget. That evening, all Lizzie had to do was...
Press these buttons... And the machine will give you what you want. Yeah. Now we'll have peace and quiet.
Yeah, there'll be a riot.
Then they kissed Lizzie goodnight and sent her off to bed. Next day...
Guess what we're doing at school today?
Shush.
Songs and singing.
Shush.
Drawing and drinking.
Shush.
Writing and reading.
Shush.
And playing. And saving our teacher from 100 dinosaurs that were all stampeding.
Shush.
Shush.
Why don't we make a listening gadget?
Good idea.
So they made a listening gadget. That evening, all Lizzie had to do was...
Press the button and the machine will listen to you all you want.
Now you try it.
Now we'll have peace and quiet.
Or there'll be a riot.
Shall I tell you what I did at school today? Well, what I did was I did sums and singing, writing and reading, drawing and drinking. Next day, Mr. and Mrs. Gizmod spent all day inventing machines to do everything for Lizzie. Now, all Lizzie had to do was...
Press these buttons and the machines will dress you.
Undress you.
Feed you.
Read to you.
Laugh at your jokes.
But best of all,
kiss you goodnight.
All right.
Now we'll have peace and quiet.
No, there'll be a riot.
Next evening, Mr. and Mrs. Gizmod sat in total silence. They hadn't seen Lizzie all day.
You know, I think I might just go and check on our Lizzie.
I'll come too.
When they got there, all they saw were remote controls and gadgets.
She's gone.
And they said quietly...
All we've got is gadgets.
Then they said very loudly...
We want our Lizzie!
Then a sound came from the wardrobe, and out came...
Lizzie!
Oh, from now on we don't want peace and quiet.
No, we want a riot.
Shot, look my hands jumping.
Clearly states.
No noise at any time. Especially now!
Thank you.